Good evening. We will be celebrating the wonderful recognition festival of Camp Orthodoxy Sunday. As it is our tradition, so welcome to the Trinity Holy Service. We would invite all of you to follow along the service books that have been provided so that we may have a more full expression of our Camp Orthodoxy and our very beloved sister. Blessed is our God, who is now forever and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Come, let us worship and bow down before God, our King. Come, let us worship and bow down before Christ, God, our King. Come, let us worship and bow down before you, Christ, our King and God.
Yes, Lord, all my soul, Lord, my God, you are magnified as He. You clothe yourself with thanksgiving and majesty. You cover yourself with lightning with the garment. Stretch out the heavens and the earth. You are who covers his eyes, upper chambers, with water, who makes the clouds and means of the world, who walks on the wings of the winds, and makes his angels spirits and his ministries in a flame of fire. He established the earth on that stable foundation. It shall not be moved unto the ages of age. The deep lake, the firmament, the deep covering, the waters shall stand upon the mountain, and who rebuke they shall pierce. Flee, at the sound of the thunder, they shall be afraid. The mountains rise up from the plains and down to the place you found for them. You said about me, they shall not pass over, neither shall they return to the cover of the earth. You are he who sends springs into the valley, and the water shall pass between the mountains. They shall give drink to all the wild animals of the field. The wild asses shall quench their thirst. The birds of the heavens shall dwell beside them. They shall sing from the midst of the rocks. You who are he who wanders the mountains from higher places, the earth shall be satisfied with the food of the world. You are he who causes grass to grow for cattle, and the green plant for the service of man, to bring forth bread from the earth, and wine that is the heart of man, to brighten his face with oil, and greatly strengthens man's heart. The trees of the plain shall be food. The cedars of Lebanon shall be planted. There, the sparrows shall make his nest. The house of the heron takes the lady among them. High mountains are for the deer. The cliff is for the refuge and rabbits. He made the moon for his seasons. The sun now is set. You established darkness in what is night. Wherein all the wild animals of the forest will prowl out. The young lions will learn his master cry and seek their food from God. The sun arises and they are gathered together, and they shall be put to bed in their beds. Man shall go out to his works and labor until evening. O Lord, your works shall be magnified greatly. You made all the things in wisdom. The earth was filled with your creation. There was great and spacious sea. The creeping things are without number. The living there are their boats, small and great. Their ships pass through. There is a dragon you formed to play therein. All things wait upon you that you may give them food in due season. When you give it to them, they shall have it. When you open your hand, all things shall be filled with your goodness. But when you turn your face away, they shall be troubled. When you take away their breath, they shall die and return again to dust. You shall send forth
And for the faithful who live in it, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
All faithful, whether they come to the priest here in the temple seasons, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by land, sea, and air, for the sake, the suffering, the captives, and for their safety and salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Thank you.
You, Lord, should mark transgressions, Lord, who should stand? For with you there is forgiveness. By the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, the prophets prophesy that you who are the incomprehensible, unoriginate, Lord, before Lucifer shone forth from the Father's immaterial, incorporeal womb would become a child, taking flesh from her who remained unwed, and joined with humanity on the earth, being visible through them, make us worthy of your illumination, gracious Lord, and we extol your ineffable resurrection.
Sine pagomenos,
ίσον συμβατήνιο στρατηγός ο Άριστος κατά των αντιθέων ηρίστευσας και νικήστροπε ηλίφθος εν μοιριάσι Χριστόν στεφή φόρος ειν αυτής παρέστηκας. be sheltered in the shelter of your wings.
Let us convey thy reading prayer to the Lord.
servants bow their heads and submissively incline their necks, awaiting God help from them, but entreating your mercy, looking confidently for your salvation. Guard them at all times, both during this present evening and in the approaching night, from every foe, from all adverse powers of the devil, from vain thoughts and evil imaginations. May the mind of your kingdom be blessed and glorified of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, to the ages of ages.
We measure in love of your infinity.
Oh.
Thank you.
made, let us rejoice and be glad in it. It is a joy to have all of you here, to be worshiping together on this day of triumph and orthodoxy as we continue. We won't let the feast go. It started Saturday night, we're just not letting it go. It's good. At this time, we have a moment to offer to you a few words, not from me myself, but I have asked Father Gregory Thompson of Holy Transfiguration here in Steubenville to offer a few words. So if you would please give him your love and attention. Thank you.
Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Christ is in this.
I
warned Father Nick that he was a neatest and has a big mouth. So I have to turn it down. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, today we come to celebrate a great victory in Orthodoxy, as my parishioners will attest. I normally don't use that term very often. But indeed, it is a great victory. And it's a holy victory. It's a victory that allows us to worship in true faith. It's a victory that allows us to honor the saints and Mother of God and to worship our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, for veneration of images of themselves. We honor the saints by venerating their image. We honor the Theotokos, the Mother of God, by venerating her image. And we worship our Lord and Savior by venerating his image. But what is the ultimate form of honor and respect? We heard this a little bit ago. I said, oh, it's a little bit. A big chunk of my sermon. Should have read it first. What's the ultimate form of honor? Imitation. Imitation is the ultimate form of honor. Are we not all created in the image and likeness of God? Go ahead, Mia. Yes? Okay. Of course we are. So how can we possibly honor God more by imitating Him? And how do we imitate? We're learning that as we go through Great Lent, learning by what? Being first humble. Is our Lord not humble? Absolutely. The epitome of it. How about something else? How about loving? Compassion. Merciful. I was joking, said, isn't that just kind of being respectful? You forget about that. To respect one another. If we don't respect one another, how can we possibly love one? If we don't respect one another, how can we possibly be humble? If we don't respect one another, how can we possibly be in the image of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. The ultimate, also the epitome of respect for everyone and all things. I told everybody at Holy Transfiguration I'd be brief. It's been a long day. So I'm going to wrap it up. My brothers and sisters, that's what Great Lent is about. I allow me to repeat myself. It's truly what Great Lent is about, is to humble ourselves, to be the imitators, to learn, to be the imitators of our Lord and God and Savior. Not only during Great Lent, but to carry it past possible
to carry God into our lives each and every day that we go out in the world, that guess what? Is not going to respect us back. And our Lord says, forgive them, Father, for they know not what they do. Something that we need to carry on our hearts. Also, as we just got done with Forgiveness Sunday, throughout the entire year. To the glory of the kingdom of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and in the ages of ages. Amen. Christ is in our midst.
He is always shall be.
Thank you.
Heavenly King, uphold our rule and strengthen the faith, calm the nations, give peace to the world, protect this holy church, and grant our departed fathers and brethren that they may dwell with the righteous and accept us in confession and repentance for your good and loving and kind. O Lord and Master of my life, do not permit the spirit of laziness and meddling, lest the power and idle talk to come into me. Instead, grant me your servant the spirit of prudence, humility, patience, and love. Yes, O Lord and King, grant me to see my own faults and not to judge my brother. We are blessed to the ages of ages. Amen. Glory to your God and our hope, glory to you. May he who is wondrous among his saints, Christ, our true flesh, to the spotless, holy, pure, mother, mother, power of the precious and life-giving cross, protection, the honorable, marvelous, powers of heaven, sanctification, the honorable, glorious, prophet, and forerunner, John the Baptist, holy, glorious, and praiseworthy, apostle, holy, glorious, and strength, martyrs, for venerable God, the ascended fathers, of the holy, righteous, ancestors of God, your kingdom, honor, and of all the saints, have mercy upon us and save us, for he is a good and merciful God, who loves mankind, through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God. Have mercy upon us and save us. May the Holy Trinity bless, protect, and keep all of you. God bless you. Please be seated just for a moment. We thank our brother clergy for being here today and for all of you from our neighboring parishes to be here. It is indeed a triumph. Orthodoxy that we can come together and worship in so many different ways. Certainly welcoming all of the clergy, of course, Father Gregory Thompson from Holy Transfiguration in Steubenville, Father Michael Cable coming from St. Nicholas in Barton, Father Michael Zahersky from St. Peter and Paul in Moundsville, Father Robbie Merritt from down the street. When I came here to Steubenville, I thought it was amazing that there were two Orthodox churches, not just in the same zip code, but on the same street. It was wonderful. From Holy Resurrection on North 4th Street. Father Frank Milanese from our Greek sister parish in Weirton All Saints. And of course, Father John Gotcha from St. Andrew's in Bingo. And hiding behind the altar is our clergy retired of the area. He serves everywhere else. Father Theoshansky, he thought I was going to forget about because he's not out front, but we'll have an opportunity to have time with him as well. So God bless you. I'm going to bring the cross out for you to venerate, and of course the icon of the Triumph of Orthodoxy as we have the opportunity at this time, so that we have an opportunity to be inside and to have our meal. It's it should be here. I will ask all the brothers, of course, brothers in there first and bless them as we have that great chance. Chanters, my goodness, as they're coming down, thank you very much to Irma and Tony for chanting this evening.
Amen.